Baby. world, globally. How y'all doing? I am your girl, Koffee, the first flowatress of house. I am inside of, I'm going to say the champagne room, because, you know, my sister is holding this down. But this is Raw Talk Live on GS Radio, Newark, New Jersey. Please call in at 973-901-9646. We got some people up in here. You know, we chilling. And I'm so honored to have this sister that's sitting next to me, Miss Chemistry, share this little moment with me. We just going to chat it up. Talk about some real girl talk, girly stuff. So, you know, it might get a little bit sensitive. But me and this sister go back 20 years, Kim?
20 plus years. Yes.
You know, she's been my friend when I was a hairstylist, which y'all don't know. I've owned plenty of beauty parlors. And I used to do Kim's hair, you know, make her look good and glamorous.
Yes,
doing it all on her
with the
own.
Deep waves and the French roll back in the day.
You
with
remember
all the
that, kid?
What?
Oh my goodness.
The higher, the bigger, the better. What?
Yes.
And
so, I'm really happy to have Kim in the house with me.
Hey, Travis.
Continue to raw talk.
Hey, cousin Charles.
This sister's deep. You know, she's really deep. She's a, when I say a friend, a lot of us women don't have those special friends that you can count on when you really need to get personal and you know it won't go nowhere. She's that sister to me. You know, she's been there for watching my kids grow up and things like that. So the sisterhood is important to me. I know we you know, deviate from it a lot. Sometimes we sisters forget that, you know, we have a special bond, especially us black women. And like I said, that's really important to me, because without a true friend, what really do you have in this world? This life is hard enough. Would you agree, Kim?
Yeah, I totally agree. Not only being sincere, but, you know, you want a friend that's going to be real, you know, not just to just co-sign anything, you know, like you have to, you know, let your friend know the things that she may not want to hear, but she needs to hear, you know, and
that's what I feel a true friend is all about.
You know, so she may get mad at you for a little while, but you know, she know that deep in her heart, everything is, it's all out of love.
Absolutely.
You know?
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Absolutely. And that's what keeping it real is all about, you know. And only your friends can really, you know, get that, girl, sit down, I gotta tell you something. And when you respect someone's opinion and you know that their friendship is real, you should never mind that honesty coming from that person. You know, Kim really amazes me, because not only is she a hardworking sister, but at a, I'm gonna say, at in her later years in life, she went back to school and got her degree.
Yes,
Kim,
yes.
I know that wasn't
well
easy for you, because many of the days I wanted her to come with me to this show and that show, and she used to say, girl, I gotta lock it down, I gotta study, I got a test in the morning. Kim, tell us about that struggle, you know.
Well, it was, you know, especially it was difficult, you know, being a single parent of twin girls, and, you know, and trying to hold it down and go to school. It was rough, and trust and believe when I tell you that wherever, if I did go out, my books went with me. My daughters, you know, would say to me, you know, like, Mom, you know, you're carrying your books to the restaurant. Yep, I'm waiting in the lobby. When everyone, once they arrive, my books went everywhere. So, you know, it's, the struggle is real, but if you put your mind to it and you're dedicated, you know, that's what you, those are the sacrifices you're going to make, you know, to achieve your goals. You know, like, shout out to my cousin Travis, who just graduated himself yesterday from Lincoln Tech, you know, doing his thing, and he's a single parent, you know, raising a daughter, you know, and that's difficult, you know, for a man to raise a young lady. So Travis, you know, you're doing your thing. You know, I'm proud of you, you know? So, yeah, it was difficult. It was a long journey, but that's what it's about. It's about the journey itself.
Absolutely.
You know, and you know, the saying goes, inch by inch, your goal's a cinch. And it's not about a race.
Right.
You know, it's not about a race. You take your time, you do it, enjoy the journey.
That's
enjoy
right.
it, you know? That's so right. It can be done. You know, it was a long time coming, but hey, sister got that paper. Hi.
Let's give it up. Make some noise for Kim, because that struggle just is not,
love you
it's,
too,
it's not easy. It's something that, you know, I really would like to do myself, but I can't even seem to find any time to, you know, to lock and load or fit in something that I really want to do, and that is go back to school and get my degree. So, Kim.
Don't believe it. She when I tell you she juggles everything, she does everything. I mean, sister out here, you know, doing shows, working on her album, doing videos, trying to write down, you know, lyrics, you know, and, you know, being a mother. I mean, she's amazing. So, you know, yeah, it can be done. You know, once you put your mind to it, it can be done. She'll do it.
Oh, see, this sister encourages me too. I'm gonna tell you, Kim got, she has two twin girls, and I'm serious. They are her pride and her joy. And twins are, if you listening right now, I know you know your mama love you, but I've seen the love that she have for you is endless. And Kim's daughters used to play basketball overseas, right, Kim?
Well, you played basketball here in Newark and all over, and they did exceedingly well. So yeah, they did well, and they played in college. They won not an athletic scholarship, but an academic, both of them, which is very, very rare for a household to get two full academic scholarships. So, you know, and yeah, they played ball when they were in school. They played in Newark. They played in tournaments, and they did really well. I'm really proud of them. You know, they're successful young women, and they're doing their numbers out here, you know, so yeah.
That's beautiful. So I mentioned that because, you know, sometimes we as sisters, we need that extra encouragement. You know, I'm going to tell you something. It's rough out here. And sometimes we feel like giving up. You're all by yourself. You're a single parent. You're not getting no help from the man. But it's okay, because I'm going to tell you, it's a lot of us with the same story, and we make it become something better than better. And this is one sister that have done so. I myself, you know, I'm proud of my daughters, and y'all all know that. So I want to say shout out to all the single moms that's out here doing a 9-to-5, struggling, working, holding it down with the rent by themselves, car notes by themselves, you know, putting food on the table, just the everyday struggle. But also I want to recognize some of you brothers, because it's not always just the sisters that's, you know, holding it down. Shout out to the brothers, and just shout out to everybody that's trying to survive, because it's really not easy out here.
Yeah. Because there is, like I said, there are some single, you know, dads out here raising children on, you know, on their own. And I commend them, you know, because, you know, it's difficult. Because, like I said, you have to, a lot of, you know, of us came up as they say, latchkey children, you know. And it's kind of rough and it's scary, especially in this, you know, day and age, too, with so much crime and violence and stuff. You know, you want to, you need to work and you put food on your table and keep a roof over your head, you know. Then you worry about how your children are doing in school. You know, you don't want them getting caught up in the wrong circles, what have you, you know. So, you know, and times are definitely changing, you know, right. So.
Right, right. And that's for sure. And so, you know, with that being said, Kim, I wanted to talk to you about, you know, the struggle with relationship and black love. You know, sometimes we as women, we look for a man to complete us, a man to define us. But throughout all of that, we have no self-love. So, what is your intake on the buildup of a relationship, a strong relationship, and what do you think is needed on both parts to make it successful?
Well, you know, I don't presume to have, you know, the answers, but what I can say, you know, to be successful within any relationship, you know, first and foremost, you don't look toward another individual to complete you, and you don't look toward another individual to make you happy. That's all within yourself. You have to have a strong foundation within yourself. You have to have that self-love, you know? So, and that's what it's all about, you know? No one, I feel like, you know, can complete you. They can compliment you, You know, they can be the gravy to your meat. You know what I'm saying?
The gravy to your meat. You got that? Okay. All right, ladies, take note. The gravy to your meat. Yeah.
Yeah, you know, but it's all with self-love. You know, you have to come strong, you know. The queen comes along with her crown, and the king seeks her out.
Ooh, do you see why this is my crown friend on. For life? You know, I love that, Kim. I love that. Yes, and that is so real. That's what's up.
Yeah.
And, you know, I've watched a lot of women, you know, settle for less. You know, and you know that they deserve more. You can see that they deserve more, but sometimes we as women, we get tired of struggling. Mm. And sometimes when you come home and we all are made to have that, to long for that man. And when you want that man in your presence, or you come home and you feeling very sexual and you don't have anyone there at night, you know, sometimes that becomes very depressing for a lot of women, you know. And I'm starting to, when I talk to my sisters, I know I've been single for a very long time, and I've been married for many, many years. So, you know, I'm very picky with, you know, with who I choose to bring into my
and
life.
Should be. Definitely.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And so what I see now in this dating scene is no titles. It's, you know, it's just, you know your place, you're here. And I see you when I see you. Everybody's afraid to make commitments. What do you think is the problem? Because I remember back in the day, see, I'm still old school.
Oh, I'm definitely old school. So
yes.
That's why I'm single, because I am so old school. You know, I won't settle. I don't have to settle.
That's right.
You know, touching back on what you had said earlier, a lot of women, you said settle for less. I think what it is, a lot of women are needy.
Yes.
You know, they're needy, and you have some women who they need to have someone in their life, and they just, what long as they have someone there, you know, doesn't matter, you know, they can't be alone. You have someone that like that, just can't be alone.
Right.
And they end up with, you know, just anything.
Right.
Just anybody.
Right.
You know, a lot of them end up with dressed up garbage cans.
Ooh.
You know.
What?
So.
Did you hear that?
Dressed up garbage cans.
Okay, go ahead, Kim.
Because everything that look good ain't good.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. And so I think that's really one reason why, you know, we stayed friends for so long, because there's been so many times, Kim, that you've come to me and just let out your heart feelings. Yeah. And you know that I love you.
Aww.
And I've come
love
to
you
in this journey of so many different levels. When I know I can't go anywhere else, I know that I can always come to you. And you're going to kick it to me real and raw.
Oh, yeah.
That's why we, listen, this is
Raw Talk
Live.
What?
And please tune in, call in, you know, all of you
CBS
women out
Radio.
There, even if you fellas out there have something to say. We're talking about relationship. We're talking about a little bit of everything. But the phone number here for GS Radio in Newark is 973-901-9646. And we are getting it in with just some chit-chatting about how, you know, about many things.
About
we're going all over the
anything.
Place.
Even if you have a question you want to ask, or there's something that you would like us to talk about, hey, give us a ring-a-ling-a-ling, and, you know, we can do this.
What?
Yes. Come on. Talk to us.
That's right.
You know?
Also, I wanted to let you ladies that are looking for a spot to get fit and trim, and just work out and have a good time. I know you got Eddie, my brother Eddie Nicholas, hosting many of your events Zumba. Kim is doing the damn thing. She's doing her Zumba classes. And I remember, Kim, if you don't mind, Kim, I'm going to just tell the story. Do you mind, Kim?
Okay.
Okay. She going to kick me under the table if I say something she don't like.
How long we going to be friends after this.
Yes. Okay. But I remember... before Kim started her Zumba class, And she was just, you know, real religious with it, going to Zumba all over the place. She really had gotten into her Zumba. And I was so proud of her because, you know, no matter how, and she gets up in the crack of dawn. She goes to work 3 o'clock in the morning. And for her to fit all of these things in her day, it really impresses me. And I said, Kim, and this is when I was at the warehouse with Charles. I said, Kim, you go to, hey, Charles McDougal. I said, Kim, you're doing all of these, you know, going to all of these classes, but I believe that you can build your own class and you can start your own movement and you can do that right here at the warehouse. And so at first, Kim, you know, she was just a little like, really? You should. I said, Kim, you got this, girl. You can do this. And Kim opened up. She started her first class. You had about how many people at your first class, Kim, at the warehouse?
I would say close to 20 people.
Yeah. Close to 20 people doing Zumba. And from there, her classes have grown. She's traveling all over, working this Zumba movement. And that's what friends are about. That's what friends should be. That's the reason why you are friends. You know, we uplift each other. We encourage one another. There's plenty of times that I sat in at Kim's Zumba class and I went to actually work out, but I was so impressed with what she was doing and how she was getting these women to feel good about herself. I couldn't even really join in. I was just looking like, look at you go, Kim. So, you know, how can people, when is your next class and what could they do to check you out, Kim?
Well, first of all, I like to say, you know, I'm a woman of a certain age, you know, and, you know, I try to lead by example. And, you know, I want women to know, you know, just because, you know, you a big, thick girl like such as myself doesn't mean you can't work out and you can't move because sister can move. You hear me?
Ooh, yes,
do
she can.
Do not underestimate me at all.
Dance all night at a party.
Okay. Oh, okay. No, but seriously, and you know, you have your ailments, you know, you get older, you know, your bones start hurting, you know, you got to keep moving, you have to keep doing something because you're sitting still, the more achy you get. And I love to dance, you know, so I don't care, I just love to dance. So, you know, Zumba, you know, it just falls into that. And so, you know, I thank, you know, Koffee here for throwing me in the deep end of the pool.
Kind of okay. Like what I did tonight.
threw me into the deep end of the pool. So, hey, yeah. And then thank you, Charles McDougal, for opening the doors to the warehouse and giving me the opportunity to hold Zumba there. And, baby, we set it off at the warehouse, okay, with the outstanding sound system.
Oh my goodness,
the wood floors. I mean, just wonderful atmosphere, and then the people that came, just wonderful, you know. And people love seeing a realistic representative of themselves, you know. So here I am, like I said, a woman of a certain age and a certain size, and I'm representing these ladies, and they felt comfortable to come out and to do Zumba, you know. So, and that's what we did, and we had a good time, and we had that camaraderie where we were like a family, you know. We still are, you know. Hey, Barbara, I don't know if you're listening, but you know, Barbara Card, I'm shouting her out because she just said how she misses her Zumba family. We're a Zumba family. I like us all to feel, you know, feel good, you know. So and that's what we, you know, we do here. And we just had a wonderful time and, you know, doing the Zumba. So, you know, I appreciate it. I love the dance, like I said, and to get it in. And I have, speaking of which, you know, yes, you asked about classes, I will start back to at a new location Wednesdays at 6:30 at the waterfront, 2 Grafton Avenue in Newark.
What?
Yes.
What?
Yes. Who?
Look at this. I mean, my sister is deep. Yes. Give her, and she going to take the whole mile. You better rock, Kim.
Thank you.
So it's 6 o'clock.
6:30. Class is an hour long.
You know, and how much is the classes?
Well, you know what? You pay a one-time $10 fee. You come in, you register. Pay $10 one time, and you can take the Zumba class and any other classes that are offered at the waterfront as much as you like. It is really a beautiful facility. They have secure parking, you know,
wow.
So yeah.
Wow.
So that's a great deal. There's no excuse. You don't have to pay those outrageous membership fees at those expensive, fancy gyms and whatnot.
$10.
Say your
$10. Client. That's it. Wednesday?
Wednesday.
6:30?
6:30.
I hope Kim see you there.
I hope to see you
and
there.
And if you want more information about that, just hit Kim up on Facebook. Chemistry Gunn is her name on Facebook. So hit her up. And
Zumba is for everyone. And plus we have a whole host of other Zumba instructors that, you know, we network with. And I'm telling you, we have some outstanding instructors, you know, that come out. We have Fionn Arvin. We have Andreen Bryan. We have Ricardo Gonzalez. I mean, so many people. We have Betty Robertson. Yes, Queen B. Yes, I did shout you out. Yes, yes, yes. And we have Nicole Zumba with Coley. I mean, it's a whole list, you know, but we will talk about them some more, you know, more in depth. You know, there's a whole host of classes that you can attend and come visit and have and do Zumba. Yes.
Yeah.
Hey, Danica.
So,
hey.
You hey, know, Sean. I mean, these things are done by some powerful women, and we're not really, you know, we don't get paid for doing any of these things. We just, you know, stepped up to the plate to do and fit in wherever we can to try to make a difference. So, you know, sometimes your support does matter. And I'm not going to say sometimes. I'm going to say every time your support do matter. And, you know, try to, you know, come out and support Kim. Try to support whatever you see that you like and the cause is positive. You know, uplift it. You don't have to agree with it or disagree with it. But if you can't be positive for someone's efforts, then you need to keep your mouth shut. Okay.
Yeah. So. And how could you not be positive about trying to be fit? You know, and people have this misconception just because you're big, you're not fit. Trust me, that's a total misconception, okay? And then also keep in mind, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. There is a whole slew of breast cancer events that are coming up. You know, this is to raise money for breast cancer awareness, for a cure. You know, we have our sisters are suffering at record numbers, okay? Record numbers, and this is outrageous. So, you know, with diet and exercise and a positive attitude, you know, I mean, your situation can change, you know, so come on out and support. Like I said, how could you not be positive about trying to be fit and just getting out and just moving and or walking? You know, not only Zumba, but, you know, we have a Girl Trek organization. They encourage women to get out there and walk. You just to walk a minimum of 30 minutes a day can change your life. You have no idea. You know, so, you know, how could you not be positive about wanting to be healthier and living a better life?
That's right. That's right. Well said, Kim. Well said, sis. You know, something else I kind of wanted to talk about, you know, we're in the midst of elections and who do we want to become our next leader of the United States of America. On this end, you got Mr. Donald Trump. And on this end, you got Miss Hillary Clinton. Where do you stand, Kim, what we're faced with, or the elements that we have, the ball that we have to play this game with? Where do you stand?
You know, I usually don't get into politics, religion, and all those other things, but I'm with the brother that was on the award show. What was his name? Jesse so-and-so? What was his name? That's who I'm with. Jesse Williams, yes. Jesse, can you hear me?
Jesse Williams.
Jesse, honey. Jesse. Throw your, please, because, you know, the real candidates, I'm telling you, this is a joke. And it's not funny. It's not funny at all. You know, the issues that are serious issues that this country is faced, nothing's being addressed. You know, there is more attacking each other's character. This is some childish mess with some old dirt bags. You hear me?
Yes,
these people
ma'am.
Is old as dust. They're so old, they've been out here since dirt been on the ground, okay? And they sitting up here, you know, throwing, you know, playing the dozens or whatever that you want to call it at one another. Come on. Address the issues. We're faced with, I mean, racism is at an all-time high. All-time high. You know, I mean, it's like way past like the 60s. And I mean, we're really regressing. This country has regressed. And it's embarrassing. You
totally
know, I'm
embarrassing.
So, you know, I'm so heartbroken that the Obamas are leaving. I mean, because they are a class act. I mean, you have to be serious. They're a class act, you know, so.
Absolutely.
Very classy.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, was so hurtful, like you said. We say Black Lives Matter, and that's one movement, but it's bigger than the police that are killing us. It's much bigger than that. Black lives should matter in every aspect of the word of Black Lives Matter. We should be uplifting one another. We come from kings and queens, and to sit back and we see these things happening. We see these. We're marching. We're trying to stand up for ourselves. But when it comes to voting, no one really goes to the poll. No one's really making that much of a difference. When we say, hey, listen, I got a movement, you know, and I want to include all of us together so that we can all band together and let our voices heard, nobody says nothing. But if you say something about a party over here or something there, then everybody joins in and want to join forces with that. But if you say something that, hey, we need to forget the party right now. The party is going to be here.
Always.
Right now, look at this world and look at what's happening. We are being taken down, taken under. You know, they coming together thinking of ways to really do us in, get rid of our black men.
Yeah.
And what are they going to have left? They're going to have us as black women here. And we ain't even going to have our black brothers to protect us. Because they trying to do everything to throw them in jail right now. And if our men are falling right into that entrapment and not rising above the bait that they're throwing out to us, we are, you know, just, what do we have? We got to find our way back to one another and become strong and maybe let our voices be heard in another way, because sometimes the marching is not always the answer.
Well, it's not enough. But what I feel, you know, first and foremost, we need a rebirth. We need a true awakening. You know, I feel like we as a people have been in a coma.
Mm.
You know, we need to come up out of it. You know, we really do. And we have to have this respect, you know, this true, I mean, deep down respect for one another. We have to look at each other like, you know, hey, we're family. We can't have this. We cannot have this war amongst ourselves right about now. All, you know, we have to get our things together amongst ourselves before, you know, we just have to help one another out right now. We have to band. There is strength in numbers, and we have to band together.
Absolutely. Absolutely, you know, Kim, and it's really hurtful. You know, I can't even bear seeing another black man just shot, hands up, and shot cold, dead, clean in the street, as if his life don't even matter, as if he don't have a family, as if he doesn't have a mother, a father, children that he's leaving behind. And to see this happening over and over and over again, it is really pissing me off. So I'm trying to think, okay, what can I do? What changes can I make? We have this GS radio. Please give us a call, 973-901-9646. Let your voice be heard. Again, the phone number is 973-901-9646. And we need to hear from you. If you have any suggestions on what we can do as black people as a whole, and not just black people, all people, we're all one people. If you have any ideas of what we can do to maybe start our own movement,
suggestions,
give us a call. Let's see how we can work this out.
We have a call.
We have a caller on on the phone, and who are we talking to? Who do we have the privilege of speaking with?
Peace, Queen. This is Trav from South Jersey. Peace.
Oh, peace to you, my brother. How are you?
Hey, Travis.
I'm all right. I'm all right, sisters. How y'all?
Oh, we're pretty good, and thank you so much for calling in.
Yes, this is Travis. He just graduated yesterday from Lincoln Tech.
Congratulations.
Doing his numbers. Yes, yes. And we're speaking of black men. So as a black man and you're raising a child on your own, how do you feel about this, you know, situation about, well, basically, I look at it like this. It's like we as black people, it's like we have targets on our back. We have these bullseyes on our back that it's hunting season. It's actually hunting season. We're not viewed as human beings, but actually as, you know, as game, you know, target practice. So, you know, and that's how I feel, and I'm disgusted by it. I'm telling you, you know, I have a knot in my throat, you know, and I'm trying not to be, you know, be one of those bitter women, but I mean, you know, I have this anger. I mean, I have a right to have my, that's another thing I don't like when people talk about, you know, oh, the angry black woman, doggone it, I have the right to feel all my damn emotions, anger, whatever the hell they are, I have the right to feel them, and I'm angry as hell. Let's just keep it real, okay? And so you as a black man, Travis, you know, I like to know your take on this situation.
Well, my take on the situation, Todd, is that a black man having a target on his back is nothing new.
That's
right. It's just more, you know, with this internet, it's more televised, and it's becoming, you know, so intolerable, you know? Yeah. And it's hard out here for a black man. It's hard in so many different ways. But at the same time, we are the people that's built to fight and get through this struggle, you know? And I think as going forward, what we have to do to start ourselves in the right direction, we got to get back into speaking to each other. When we see each other out there on the street, we wave and say, yo, have a good day, black man. Hey, how you doing, sister? Open the door. We have to empower ourselves on a daily basis, remind ourselves that we got each other's back and keep striving to move forward. Shows like this, chances for us to speak, chances for us to reach out to other people is what's going to bring us over top. Our day is coming. We have to stay strong, people.
Yes, that's yes. Right. Have that basic respect. And that's what it's all about respect.
Travis, what are the things that maybe you have experienced, and how did you handle it, and what can you give to the next brother that might have experienced some racism with the police, or what is your suggestions on that?
Oh, man, that's a big question. I mean, the thing about our brothers and sisters that's different is that we've all have experienced some form of racism some way or another. Like, it's gonna happen, you know? Right. How you deal with it is you gotta keep a cool, calm head when you're in that situation or whatever it may be. You have to know that that oppressor can't oppress you because you are a descendant of a king and a queen, you know? You have to shake it off, shrug it off, keep it moving. If there's a way to, you know, find a superior, like say if you're dealing with a police officer and you know, you straight being disrespected, and you know that it would be a different situation if this person in front of you didn't have a gun and a badge.
You have to
be smart enough to either get that badge number and go to a superior the next day, or whatever you have to do to get out of that situation to stay alive. That day, you come back the next day and start your fight the right way.
Travis, thank you. Thank you, brother. Absolutely. And I notice a lot of us, we're afraid. You know, when the police, you know, pull us over, we don't know our rights. We don't get any badge numbers. We don't say, you know, I'm not allowing. We have the right to say, I'm not allowing you to search my bag. You know, we have rights, and we really don't know what these rights are. And they're taking advantage of. I remember, you know, even with myself, many years ago, I grew up in the project, Little City. Shout out to Little City, the Bitty. I need to shout out to many of those people there, but. But I remember coming home one day. I was coming home from a nightclub, and two police officers, two white cops, was in the car. And so they said, hey, you, come here for a minute, you know. So I walked over to the car, not thinking of anything. They took my pocketbook and just poured everything out on the ground. You know, humiliated me so bad. And they said, you know, you fit the description. There was something going on in the neighborhood. And, you know, absolutely. And so when they dumped all of my belongings out of my pocketbook, I didn't think to get the police car number. I didn't think to do, I was just so humiliated. But I always remember that. And, you know, it just sticks with me. So now I'm very equipped. If a police come to me, I know my rights. I know what to say. I know what to do. But a lot of us don't know. Well, you know, a lot of us don't know. And if you do know, they really hate when you do know.
That's true. But sometimes,
I'm sorry you had to go through that. But we have to remember, 90% of a police conviction is from the, I don't know, suspect or whatever they want to label you as, admitting your own guilt. You have to be on your toes with these police.
Right.
They ask you questions like, hey, can I search you? Or stuff like that. You have to be keen in that. If this is a question, you have the right to say no.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? You have to be on your toes. You can't be out there slipping when it comes to them. And if you have somebody with you or us as a people, if we see something going down, pull that cell phone out. You know, don't
That's
look
right.
suspicious and get shot, but record it.
That's Hold right, Travis.
See what that, happens next, you know? We got to look out for us.
Yes. That's Thank so you, true. Travis. Thank you so much for calling in and sharing, you know, with us, you know, and that's what we have to keep in mind that, you know, like when you're in the heat, you know, the heat of the situation, a lot of times, you know, you're not thinking right then and there, you know, about getting the badge number. You know, like sometimes the situation could be so volatile, you know, like I said, you're not thinking about, you know, what steps I should take. That's why I commend that sister who recorded her boyfriend
that was shot.
And did that, and she was so calm, cool, and collective.
Was.
I mean, and people questioned that, you know, but, you know, in that situation like that, even, you know, down to her baby, and it's a shame that she said that she had to train her own baby about how to keep calm in such a volatile situation, you know? So
unfortunate, but that's what we have to do.
Right.
We have to do it. We have to protect your neck out there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, thank you, Travis, for calling.
All
and,
right.
You know,
I love you. Slide your mic up a little bit because you're hiding behind it. But, yes, I love you. Thank you for the show.
Thank you, Travis.
Thank you for
calling
me
in.
Thank you for putting me on blast, Travis.
I'm trying
love
to
you.
Help you know, that's
no,
all.
I know.
Good
love
good
you.
Good. Love y'all. Thank
peace
you.
And love, brother.
All right. Peace.
Peace.
Please feel free to call in. We are talking about everything that's important right now. Raw Talk Live is going on GS Radio North. Please call in at 973-901-9646. I am your girl, Koffee, the first floatress of house, and I'm honored to be here with my sister,
Chemistry.
Yes. And so, you know, even with the workplace, I've noticed, you know, a lot of racism, and you see it happening, you know, in the workforce, and pretty much, you know, we live. Hey, listen,
yes.
The dial tone. So what? But
someone
know.
Else trying to call in. We on a busy signal.
You know, probably haven't heard that tone in a long time with the cell phone and everything, right?
Yeah. But you knew your heads. That's a busy signal. You know what I'm saying? You don't know nothing about that.
That's what's up. But I noticed, you know, even on my job, you know, and you know you experience a lot of racism.
Yes,
you see the a certain group of people constantly moving up in a ladder, and then you know you as a sister or that brother over there been working here for many, many years, working his butt off, but you never see the same opportunity being presented to that person. And you know, so much that we have to endure as black people. And for us not to really, you know, stand firm with each other, we need to really evaluate ourselves, because we are as strong as we make ourselves become. And you know, what I don't like, you know, on my job, sometimes you see, I mean, I'm gonna say kiss ass. Kiss ass will go to the boss man and tell on their own brother man, rather than coming to the brother man to say, listen, I seen you doing so-and-so, you know, be careful with that, instead of that. And so it reminds me sometime of a slave mentality.
Of course, that's definitely what it is. Yeah, that's just I call them chain brains. That's what they are. They chain brains. You know, but see, what they don't realize, they fail to realize, is that when they do go to the boss and, you know, and they're telling telling on their, you know, fellow brother man, you know, the boss is looking at him with the side eye and saying, I got to watch you because you like to tell, you know. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you're really shooting yourself in the foot, you know. Like, you know, be a man. You know, and there's some, you know, talk to one another. That's another thing, you know, I am old school. And that's why, you know, like sometimes I feel like this social media makes you more antisocial. At least, it makes you more antisocial.
Absolutely.
Because you don't have that human connection. You know, it's right. All this bent head, all
right.
This.
Right.
Walking
right.
Down the street, you know, text messaging, you know, real type of conversation. People don't know how to hold conversations. And, you know, so it makes you, you know, antisocial. You know, you need to know how to put down the electronics. I tell you one thing, we had a major shutdown, electricity and internet down, whatnot. A lot of you all won't survive, but I bet you who will. This old school, these two heads right here.
Holla.
And our age group, we'll survive, honey. We know how to use the old typewriter, old cash register.
That's how I learned.
Cell phone. What?
What, 65 words per
you
minute.
You all don't even know how to use a regular manual can opener. What you talking about? Y'all be some hungry asses. That's what you'll be.
You talking about Willis, that's right. I love this woman so much. And, you know, I'm just, sometimes you have to, you know, reach outside of the box. And no, my sister is not really an entertainer, but she's real and she's raw. And if you know anything about me, you know, I, no matter what, I don't really care about the big lights and glamour and things like that. Those that know me know that I just like shit real. You know, I don't have to be here and there. I just like shit raw and 100. And your sister is definitely 100. And I'm just happy that she's here with me.
Let me tell you something.
I see all of y'all tuning in. Thank you.
I may not be an entertainer, but let me tell you something about this sister. I can give a party. You understand what I'm saying?
Oh, my goodness.
What? That's what sister, I can give a party.
Oh, my goodness.
What?
Can she? I mean, and not only give a party, when you talk about making drinks that will knock your butt out.
I can give a party. Let me tell you something. I gave a party, but the police came. Knocking at the door.
Until the cops come knocking.
Oh, what? One to join the party. Hey, drinks in the tub. That's that old school. Woo! Y'all don't know nothing about that.
Nah, man. And those are the days I miss.
Yeah,
those are the days I miss.
Andrine.
Those are the days I miss, George. I see you, George and John, Malik, my brothers. I love y'all to bits and pieces. Thank you so much for tuning in. We are missing my other sister, Coco, Phyllis Leaf, but she just got stuck in traffic, so she will be joining us next month. And unfortunately, you know, I'm happy that my sisters are joining me because I was doing the show every Thursday, but because my schedule is very heavy, you know, my sisters decided to come in, join in, make the load a little bit lighter. So we're going to try to discuss if they're going to continue every Thursday. But right now we're doing this show once a month. So make sure you tune in. We'll always advertise when the next show will be toward the end of the month on a Thursday.
That works for you, Kim.
It works for me.
So we're setting it up right now, in front of y'all.
Yes, yes, we're going to have some guests come in. Oh, yes, you know, shout out to my to Quan Brandon and whatnot. We have people that do the spoken word. Yes, yes, and have special guests, Betty Robinson. We have some Zumba instructors that come in and talk about fitness. We have those that talk about natural hair care, Sister Gunn. We have Tony Gunn. We have Nicole Jones come in and talk about natural hair care and fitness. So, and we have Lorraine Gunn who come in as a representative, Girl Trek captain, to talk about Girl Trek. And you know, so we have a lot of things lined up for you.
Absolutely. I want to shout out my manager, Ronald Wally B. Johnson. I just wanted to take a moment, too, to shout out Ronald and Sutan Burwell for putting together, look at my face, marvelous show on the pier. You guys really, really did the damn thing. And you made me so proud to be a part of something so wonderful. And, you know, bringing all of us artists together like that to share the stage. We had, some of us hadn't seen each other in a very long time. You know, it was just phenomenal. And brothers, I would like to say, you know, please do it again. Because this is something that, you know, it brings happiness, it brings joy, and it was exciting, and you guys really did a wonderful job, and publicly, I wanted to just let you all know. I want to shout out my brother Lance McGraw. I see him watching. I love you. My blood brother has always been there.
Hey, Lance.
You know, my one and only blood brother, and my best friend in the world, so I want to shout him out, too. I see you watching. But, you know, Kim, this has been just wonderful. There's some people that's in the building that I need to shout out, like my sister Anita Gunn. Anita, you want to say Anita Gunn? Let me tell you,
Gunn.
She's here, just got this here
she's
camera
resident,
flicking away, flicking
she's our
away.
Resident Zumba photographer.
Yes.
Yes. You want to check out some photos, go to Facebook, you know, photos by A.G. Mathis. That's Anita Gunn Mathis, and she is phenomenal.
Bad.
Phenomenal with
Bad.
The camera. Yes,
And so she's just flicking away. I got my man in the house, Mr. Michael Gibbs, over there just chilling out, you know, making some faces at me. I don't know what the faces mean. He trying to tell me some stuff, but I ain't paying no damn attention.
Hey, Riley,
and I got my sister, you know, Champagne. I'm telling you, this sister is awesome. The sister that is in holding it down with the GS Radio, bringing all of us artists together, me and, you know,
hey,
so many others. She is an engineer of this station. Not only is she an engineer of this station, but she's in charge of many programs for the youth. So please go to Tanya Champagne. Go to her page. Check out her work. She's very productive in the community. And I love the sister because I'm going to tell you something. It's hard for me to be here, and y'all know it's hard for me to be here, but the sister will not let me go, will not let me quit. And I love her so much. I am truly a fan of this woman. And Tanya, I love you, babe,
much. I just met her. I'm a fan of hers, too. I'm a fan, too, you know?
But again, I want to say thank you for tuning in to GS Radio Nork Raw Talk Live.
Raw.
With my girl, who?
Chemistry.
And your girl, Koffee, the first floatress of house. And I want to say peace. Please, don't forget, next month, October, we will announce the date on a Thursday evening. I guess it's going to be on a Thursday,
right? This is the last Thursday of October. But remember, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Go out, support, put on your pink. Men, you can throw on a pink tie, some pink socks, put on some pink, you know. Come out and support.
We wearing pink next
what?
Month? We wearing pink next month, so I'm sure you're going to want to tune in.
Oh,
so
party coming, October 14th and whatnot, Cancer for a Cure out there at the Ramada Inn, 160 Frontage Road. You better come out there, see Vet Carol on Facebook for tickets. Hello.
Ow. We're going to also have my brother Tamir. Tamir, you know, I got you. I want you here next month. And we will be talking to, you know, some DJs that's in the house community that works hard. You know, they really work hard making this happen and keeping this music live. So, again, thank you for tuning in to Raw Talk Live. I am your girl, Koffee, the first floatress of house. And you are inside of GS Radio Newark, New Jersey. The phone number here is 973-901-9646. I think tomorrow my brother Devious, I love Devious so much, but my brother Devious will be
MC.
Rocking the mic tomorrow. So again,
peace out.
And thanks for tuning in.
Mwah.